Please be seated.
Great to see you, Matt.
Good to see you.
Great working with you in 2013.
You still got more to do?
Got a lot of love, man.
Good.
Will the House come to order? Mr. Clerk.
Aloha and good afternoon. Today's invocation will be delivered by Pastor David Waxer Tipton of One Love Ministries. Will the members who wish to participate please rise?
Aloha and good afternoon. I want to start my blessing this morning with a true story that's a blessing to me and to set the tone for my invocation for us today. The story was told to me of a father who got on a public transit train with two children. And as he got on that train, he sat down and stared out the window while his children ran up and down the aisle. And the kids were being very unruly and they were screaming as they ran up and back and down and being very much a nuisance. And everyone began to look around like we do and say, "Would you do something about your children?" And everyone began to think, kids these days, and oh, parents these days, and why don't they take care of their children? And so everyone began to stink eye to this dad while he just stared out the window, and they were very upset at this dad and these unruly children. Finally, one person had enough courage to go up to him and say, "Sir, are you going to do something about your children?" And he said, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry. We just lost their mother. And we're just coming from the hospital just now. I apologize. I wasn't paying attention." And everyone on the train went from animosity to compassion. See, nothing changed but perspective. And I think sometimes that's what we need as public servants, that do we sometimes presuppose that our perspective is the perspective? The great humorist Josh Billings, he was a contemporary of Mark Twain. He says, "It ain't so much the things we don't know that get us into trouble, it's the things that we do know that just ain't." And that's so, so helpful. So my goal in life is that I seek for information before I make any proclamation. Amen? Epulikako. Heavenly Father, I thank you now for this day to be with these servants. God, I pray that you would let them know that there is a privilege to have wisdom and discernment, Lord God, and that we would not just come to conclusions based on our own understanding. I am thankful for the privilege today to pray for these each individuals as they have families, they have lives, they have communities to serve and to care for. So I pray for strength and endurance. I pray that each one of us, God, would put on a heart of compassion and kindness and humility and patience, and that we would bear with one another, forgiving one another, as you've shown us to do so. So bless Hawaii'ine, bless these persons here today as we serve this great state of ours. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pastor Waxer. Mr. Clerk, can you please call the roll?
Mr. Aquino, Ms. Bilotti, Mr. Brower, Mr. Cachola.
He's here.
Mr. Choi, Mr. Cregan, Mr. Cullen, Ms. DeCoit, Ms. Evans, Ms. Fukumoto Chang, Ms. Har, Mr. Hashem, Ms. Ichiyama, Mr. Ng, Mr. Ito, Mr. Johansson, Ms. Jordan, Mr. Kawakami.
Excused.
Mr. Keoho Kalole, Mr. Kobayashi, Mr. Kong.
Excused.
Mr. Lee, Mr. Lopresti, Ms. Lowen, Ms. Luke?
Excused.
Ms. Matsumoto? Mr. McDermott? Mr. McKelvey? Ms. Morikawa? Mr. Nakashima? Mr. Nishimoto? Mr. Ono? Mr. Onishi? Mr. Oshiro? Mr. Puha? Mr. Rhodes?
Excused.
Mr. Saiki? Ms. San Buenaventura? Mr. Say?
Excused.
Mr. Suki? Mr. Takayama? Mr. Takumi? Ms. Thielen? Mr. Tokioka? Mr. Tsuji? Ms. Tupola? Mr. Ward? Mr. Woodson? Mr. Yamane? Mr. Yamashita? Mr. Speaker?
Here.
Mr. Speaker, 46 members are present, 5 are excused.
Thank you very much. Reading of the journal, Representative Evans.
Mr. Speaker, may this matter be deferred.
So ordered. Thank you very much. Mr. Clerk, are there any messages from the governor?
Yes, Mr. Speaker, we are in receipt of governor's message number 15 informing the House of proposed changes to the fiscal year 2017 executive supplemental budget. May this matter be received and filed.
So ordered. Thank you very much. Mr. Clerk, are there any Senate communications?
Mr. Speaker, there are none.
Thank you very much. Members, are there any introductions? Yes, Representative Takayama, followed by Representative Woodson.
Mr. Speaker, I'd like to introduce members of my session staff who have decided to treat themselves for the first time to watching a House floor session from the gallery. If I may, they are Sheldon Galdera, my committee clerk, Kawi Lucas, and Aristotle Santa Cruz. I might mention, please welcome them to our house. I might mention that Aristotle is former band director at Kamehameha Schools, and he often says that one of his outstanding tuba players is the minority floor leader. And I might mention that it is also Aris's birthday today. So thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Representative Woodson.
Oh, thank you, Speaker. With us today in the gallery, we have a very capable individual. And with us today, instead of spending time on her spring break, you know, Jolie Correa is with us, if she can please stand. And, you know, most people on spring break right now, they are playing PlayStation, Black Ops 3, or they're going to the beach, or they're going to the mall. Jolie decided to spend her spring break interning in her office. So she's a very capable individual. And I didn't know her very well, and I said, Jolie, you know, what high school do you go to? And she kind of looked at me with a strange face. So I said, oh, I apologize, you graduated from high school already. And then she paused for a second, and she said, I go to EL, as in EL Intermediate. So she's very capable, she presents herself very well, and it should come at no surprise, Speaker, because she is the granddaughter of a individual that a lot of us know, the Senator Joseph Tanaka. So if we can please give her a warm round of applause. Tongue-tied, Speaker. I need more coffee, more coffee. With us today also is Makoa, and he is a team member in our office. Please stand and be recognized. And Speaker, may their names be entered into the journal, please.
So ordered.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further introductions, members? Yes, Representative Takumi.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. We have a number of people in the gallery that I'd like to introduce. First of all, someone who really doesn't need an introduction because he has been honored on the floor of the House in the past, but we have Keith Hayashi, the principal of Waipahu High School. So on behalf of Representative Cullen Yamani and Aquino, please welcome Principal Hayashi. Today also was Charter School Day at the Capitol, Mr. Speaker, as you know, and representing the charter schools in Hawaii, we have Janine Suki, the Executive Director of the Hawaii Public Charter School Network. And let me read off the names of some of the staff that we have here and principals, and if you can hold your applause till I get through all the names. First of all, we have Heather Nakakura from West Hawaii Exploratory Academy Public Charter School. We also have Kalei Makamai Kaowai from Kawaikini Public Charter School. We also have Kamaka Gunderson from Keana Lahana Public Charter School. Daniel Kalua from the Viola Public Charter School. Ushna Kotner, and also Pat Brandt, a board member of Halau Kumana. Members, please welcome charter school people.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further introductions? If not, floor presentations, Mr. Clerk. Are there any floor presentations today?
Yes, Mr. Speaker, we have one floor presentation today, House Resolution Number 160, congratulating Michael Sana as the recipient of the 2015 Milken Educator Award, Raina Fairchild as the 2015 Voya Unsung Heroes Award recipient, Jan Camilla as the 2015 Public Librarian of the Year, Anna McCormick as the recipient of the 2015 Excellence in Service Award, and Orrin Smith, Brittany Akau, Philip Palmore, and Anna Kimata as recipients of the 2016 Prudential Spirit of Community Award. This resolution is offered by Representatives Takumi and Ono.
Thank you very much. Representative Takumi.
Mr. Speaker, move for the adoption of the resolution.
Thank you very much. Representative Ono.
Mr. Speaker, I second the motion.
Thank you very much. It's been moved and seconded that the resolution be adopted. Any discussion? Representative Takumi.
Speaker, rise in support of the resolution.
In support. Please proceed.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Today, we are honoring teachers, librarians, and students for their work and passion for the community and their peers. I ask the honorees to stand as your name is called. Our first honoree is Mr. Michael Sano, a teacher at Waipahu High School, who has earned the 2015 Milken Educator Teacher of Promise Award. Mr. Speaker, if you were fortunate enough to be there when Mr. Sano's name was announced at the gymnasium and some of us who represent Waipahu were there, I'm sure the Department of Health would have cited the school because the decibel level in that gym exceeded the noise level that's acceptable. It was pretty incredible. Mr. Sano's hard work and passion for science led to his students' unprecedented level of success. If you ever attend the Leeward District Science Fair, you'll know what I mean when many, many of the awardees are from Waipahu High School. He serves as the chair for the school's science department, where he has helped to increase program participation in the advanced placement biology class from 12 when he first started there to currently 40 students who participate in AP biology. He has also secured a Gear Up federal grant and established teacher mentorships at the prestigious Lawrence Livermore Teacher Research Academy. And despite his own challenges that he has faced in his life, he has persevered and made a difference in the lives of his students, colleagues, and community. Members, please welcome Mr. Michael Sano. Next, we have Ms. Raina Fairchild of Manoa Elementary School, who has earned the 2015 Voya Financial Unsung Heroes Award. Ms. Fairchild created a learning space for students while at Waikiki Elementary School's library called Let's Make a Maker Space. With various supplies and the imagination and creativity of young minds, Ms. Fairchild allowed students to create projects in this special space. Ms. Fairchild also provided students at Waikiki Elementary with a forum to express their creativity and the freedom to reveal their artistic side while learning, exploring, and discovering themselves. Members, Ms. Fairchild. Now, Mrs. Speaker, for all of us who have gone to public libraries when we were young, and I know we always remember the library and going, shh, well, it's a whole different ballgame now with the libraries. Yes, my colleague to my left remembers it very well. Ms. Jan Camilla from Makali Mo'ili'ili Public Library is our 2015 Librarian of the Year. Having served the past 14 years as both a volunteer and permanent staff to the public library system, Jan is an exemplary model of devotion to the educational system. Ms. Camilla has helped to ensure that information and resources of the library are available to the public, as well as promoting the importance and enjoyment of reading to young adults. Members, please welcome Ms. Jan Camilla. We also have Ms. Anna McCormick of Waihewa Public Library, who is the recipient of the 2015 Excellence in Service Award. In 1984, Ms. McCormick worked as a custodian at Bililani Community Library. In 1993, Ms. McCormick was inspired to begin working as a library assistant at Waihewa Public Library, where she has been serving ever since. Ms. McCormick serves the patrons of the library with compassion and dedication. Members, Ms. Anna McCormick. Mr. Speaker, I will now defer the introduction of the remaining award recipients to your Vice Chair of the Committee on Education, Representative Takashi Ono.
Thank you very much, Representative Ono.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and support.
And support, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I continue these awardees. It's my privilege to honor here today to celebrate achievements made by some of Hawaii's middle and high school students. These students have shown exemplary community service and volunteerism and serve as role models for their peers. Our first recipient is Oren Smith, who is a 2016 Prudential Spirit of Community Award honoree. Oren is a sixth grader at Hanalani School who organized a disaster preparation presentation for students and families at his school. Oren arranged for a Coast Guard officer to speak and created handouts for students to take home. Hawaii's isolation and vulnerability to natural disasters inspired Oren to plan this student assembly, which reached over 155 families in his community. Oren realized that the project made a difference because many students asked questions and were engaged in this presentation. Members, congratulations, Oren Smith. Our next recipient is Brittany Akau, who unfortunately could not join us today. She's a Prudential 2016 Prudential Spirit of Community Award finalist. Brittany is a sophomore at Kauai High School and has completed the Gift of Aloha book drive to provide students in Hawaii with books. Brittany was motivated to complete this project as a way to decrease illiteracy and to help other students understand Hawaiian culture. Brittany has also worked to decrease bullying by talking with second graders about her personal experiences and donating books about the topic to these classrooms. Our next honoree is Philip Palmore, who is a 2016 Prudential Spirit of Community Award finalist. Philip is a senior at Keao High School and organized a walkway and garden project for residents of the Hilo Medical Center Extended Care Facility. Philip was inspired to develop an ADA-compliant space when he learned that residents were not allowed to go outside because of environmental safety concerns. Philip involved the community with his efforts, from collaborating with an architect to improve his design, to requesting supplies and funding. Members, congratulations, Philip Palmore. We also have Anna Kamita, who is a 2016 Prudential Spirit of Community Award honoree. Anna is a sophomore at Punahou School and worked to organize a school supply drive to send educational resources to the small Pacific island of Palau. Anna was inspired to complete this project during an internship at the state capitol, where she learned about smaller countries that not have access to school supplies. Her goal for the students was to cultivate their love of learning and give them the knowledge to pursue their dreams. Members, congratulations to Anna Kimata. And we also have Mr. Todd Thacker, Vice President of Governmental Affairs at Prudential Financial. Mr. Thacker works to recognize students like the ones you saw today who make a difference in their communities. Through these Prudential Spirit of Community Awards and Mr. Thacker's hard work, students are able to celebrate their success and help inspire other students to give back to their schools and neighborhoods. Thank you, Mr. Thacker, for your help with celebrating these students' achievements. Mr. Speaker, we have a long list of family members, colleagues, and folks from Prudential up in the gallery. May I ask everyone who's accompanying someone on the floor who's sitting in the gallery, may you please stand up? And members, let's recognize these family, friends, colleagues, and Prudential. I may have permission to enter their names into the journal.
So ordered.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. If all the honorees can rise one more time. Mr. Speaker and colleagues, these individuals have proven themselves worthy of being honored as role models for the people of their community. Let's give them a well-deserved round of applause. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion on the resolution before us before we take a vote? If not, this will be by voice vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried. Resolution's adopted. Representative Takumi, please proceed with the presentation of the congratulatory certificates and lay. The chair will call a recess to allow the members of the House to meet and congratulate the honorees. Recess.
Majority members, caucus room, bill digest, please.
Members of the House, please be seated.
Will the House come to order? We're on item number 6, reports of standing committees, Representative Psyche.
Mr. Speaker, I move to adopt SCR numbers 1127-16 through 1133-16 on pages 2 and 3, and that the respective Senate bills, as may be amended, pass second reading and be referred to their designated committees.
Thank you very much, Representative Evans.
Mr. Speaker, I second the motion.
Thank you very much. It's been moved and seconded. This will be by voice vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. I jumped again. Members, we're actually going to have a discussion on these second reading bills. So I'm sorry. Made a mistake here. In any case, it's been moved and seconded. Discussion on these measures, top of page 2, STANCOM report number 1127. Any discussion? STANCOM report number 1128, discussion. Speaker, yes, Representative Ward.
Speaker, in support with a brief comment.
Please proceed in support.
Speaker, I was impressed with the role models that we just commended for their access and their success and their achievements for education. I just had read the bill prior to giving them congratulatory remarks, and I said, hey, how does the level of reimbursement here, the tax exemption, if you buy school supplies, you get up to $250? And they said, oh, that's really low. I said, should it be 1,000? Should it be 750? They said, no, 500 would be fair. So, Mr. Speaker, I would hope as this bill carries on that the rather low bar at 250 would be raised a bit, because I don't think in intuitive sense 250 is very much. You can't buy too much for a whole year for $250. For those reasons, I hope it's going to be considered to be higher. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion, members? Yes, Representative Jordan.
With reservations, Mr. Speaker.
So ordered.
First, permission to submit comments into the journal.
Yes, so ordered.
Just one comment on the floor. This is a dollar-for-dollar tax credit. When we start talking about tax liability, if our average tax for an individual in the state of Hawaii is about 8%, and you multiply 8 times 1,000, that's $80. And you're talking $250, dollar for dollar. That gets rather expensive in our tax coffers. And I'll submit the rest of my comments into the journal. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion, members? If not, thank you. We're going to move on to STANCOM report number 1129. Discussion. STANCOM report number 1130. Discussion. Top of page 3, STANCOM report number 1131, discussion. STANCOM report number 1132, any discussion? STANCOM report number 1133, discussion. Representative McKelvey.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have serious reservations on this measure.
So ordered.
With just comments to the journal, and just would like to say that I think fiscal responsibility would be if you have a percentage, that's when the counties would exercise fiscal responsibility, because if revenues drops and everybody suffers the downturn, I think a set cap dollar amount is not the way to go, and I think to make it permanent at this time is also gives me a lot of concern. So WR, thank you.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion, members? Representative Ward.
Speaker, I will vote with the counties. No vote.
No vote, so ordered. In opposition. Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion, members? Yes, Representative Morikawa.
Just reservations, please.
So ordered. Thank you very much, Representative. Further discussion, Representative Tupola.
With reservations, please.
So ordered. Thank you very much, Representative DeCoit.
Mr. Speaker, reservations.
So ordered.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Representative. Representative Woodson.
Reservations, please, Speaker.
So ordered. Thank you very much, Representative. Further discussion, members? If not, now we're going to be taking that voice vote on these second reading bills. All those in favor signify by saying aye. All those opposed say no. The motion is carried. Representative Evans.
Mr. Speaker, I move to suspend the rules of the House in order to consider certain Senate bills for a third reading by consent calendar.
Thank you very much, Representative Puha.
Mr. Speaker, I second the motion.
Thank you very much. It's been moved and seconded. Any questions on this motion, procedural motion, that is? If not, this will be by voice vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no. The motion is carried. Representative Psyche.
Mr. Speaker, I move that the Senate bills identified on page 4 pass third reading.
Thank you very much. Representative Evans.
Mr. Speaker, I second the motion.
Thank you very much. It's been moved and seconded. Discussion on these third reading bills. Top of page 4, Senate Bill 2312, Senate Draft 1, House Draft 1. Discussion. Thank you. Senate Bill 2825, Senate Draft 1. Speaker, discussion. Representative Ward.
Speaker, no vote.
Opposition, please proceed.
With the request that my remarks from the second reading would be entered into the journal for this third reading.
So ordered.
Because, Mr. Speaker, without NASA, there's no aerospace program. It's simple as that. This is cutting the nose despite the face. For those reasons, I continue to vote no. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Representative. Any further discussion on the measure before us, Representative McKelvey?
Just in support, Mr. Speaker.
In support, please proceed.
And NASA has been wanting off this board for quite some time. They never show up. We can't get quorum to do the other business, to do anything. And actually having them on there, in their words, is cutting off our nose despite our face. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative. Any further discussion on Senate Bill 2825, Senate Draft 1? If not, Representative Evans, for the vote.
Mr. Speaker, on the two measures before us, all majority members vote aye.
Thank you very much, Representative Puha.
Mr. Speaker, thank you. On the measures before us, all minority members vote aye, with the following exceptions: STANCOM report 1125-16, Senate Bill 2825, Senate Draft 1. Representative Ward votes no.
Thank you very much. Have all votes been cast? Did we miss anybody? Appearing that all votes have been cast, said Senate bills pass third reading. Members, are there any announcements? If there is no announcements, Representative Evans.
Mr. Speaker, I move the House stand adjourned until 12 noon tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Representative Puha.
Mr. Speaker, I second the motion.
Thank you very much. It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye. All those opposed say no. The motion is carried. The House stands adjourned until 12 noon tomorrow.